Good morning, everybody. Today we start with our presentation on a part of the self-management skill, which is personality. Every day we use this word, in our day-to-day life, in our day-to-day discussion, the word personality is being used again and again. Now, what does personality mean? Let me tell you that the word personality was derived from a Latin word by the name of persona, which was persona. And persona was basically the mask used by actors in the Roman theater for changing their facial makeup. Then this word personality evolved from the word persona. And why was this word derived? Let me tell you is that after putting on this particular mask, the audience expected the person to perform their role in a certain manner. It did not, however, mean that the person enacted that particular role necessarily, which possessed that qualities. For a lay person, personality refers to the physical or external appearance of an individual. For example, when we find somebody who is very good looking, we think same way that the person must be having a very charming personality. All right. So, exact definition of personality is our characteristic ways of responding to individuals and to situation. For example, some people are very warm by nature. Some people are very insensitive by nature. Some people are very shy. Some are very outgoing. So they are very unique qualities which are stable in the sense that they remain throughout the lifetime of an individual that characterize an individual's behavior across different situations over a period of time. So personality has certain features. Number one, there are both physical and psychological components. Physical components, as I told you, the way the person looks, and psychological is, of course, demonstrated by his behavior. In terms of expression of his behavior, there is something unique that we try to discover in each and every individual, which is a part of personality. Personality is fairly stable because the qualities, they do not change over a period of time. It is dynamic. Some of the features of personality may change. Now, for example, if a person was, an extrovert, he used to mix up with people, maybe the kind of situation that he comes across or maybe the kind of work setting that he comes across, he becomes more extrovert. All right. Similarly, the person was a shy person, but maybe because of the kind of job that he is doing, he has come out of his cocoon and he has started mixing with people, though not as much as an extrovert individual, but still he is able to put up his best when he is into any kind of social relation. So that is what we consider by the changing aspect or the dynamism of personality, that the features, they may change over a period of time. So once we are able to characterize somebody's personality, we can predict how that person will behave in a variety of circumstances. You must be making this prediction in your day-to-day life. Now, coming to something which is very important, this was given by two psychologists. These are the five big personality dimensions, and they have been given by Paul Costa and Robert McCrary. These were the two psychologists who have given the big five personality dimensions. And the big five personality dimensions are agreeableness, openness, extroversion, neuroticism, and conscientiousness. Agreeable people, my dear students, are those, who are able to help others, be cooperative with others, friendly, caring, nurturing. But on the other extreme are those people who are very self-centered. Then we have conscientious. Conscientious means governed by conscience, right? They are very dependable kind of people. They will never deviate from their principles. They're very responsible, very prudent, very practical minded, very hardworking in their life. But there are people who are opposite to conscientious and they are called impulsive, who do things without thinking of anything. Then we have neuroticism. Neurotics, these are those categories of people who are very emotionally unstable in terms of their mood and they suffer from anxiety and depression problems. They are called neurotics. And they're very distressed, fearful, irritable, hypersensitive, hypertension. But on the opposite side are those people who are well adjusted. Coming to extroversion, you must have come across the term extrovert and introvert in your everyday usage of words. Extroverts or extraversion, as the characteristic is called, these people are socially active, very, very outgoing, assertive. They learn to say no and talkative. But the opposite of those people who are not assertive, who are shy and who are introvert. Then we come to something which is called openness to experience. Life is full of challenges. So these people who are open to experience are very, very curious. You know, they have a sense of aesthetics, that is sense of beauty. They believe in actions. They believe in variety of ideas. They're very, very open and flexible to ideas. And also interested in cultural pursuits. That means they're very much interested in the other cultures and how to mix with them and, you know, how to pursue that those cultures and get information, gather knowledge. But those people who are not so flexible, they are considered as rigid. So these are the five personality dimensions which you need to know. One is agreeableness. Then you have conscientious, then neuroticism, extroversion, and openness. Coming to the next basic personality traits, as we have already discussed this, this slide again defines what I just told you, openness, conscientiousness, extroversion, agreeableness, and neuroticism. I hope these dimensions are clear to you. Now, how does personality influence us? An individual's personality affects all aspects of an individual's performance, how she reacts or how he reacts to situations in life. People who are not willing to take any challenges will shy away from challenges, will be escaping. Individuals who are not having clarity in their goals, they will definitely be very confused. But those people who are having clarity in their goals, who are determined people, they will pursue them. Similarly, there are people who get swayed away by worries and challenges, and that is why they suffer from anxiety and stress. And they can be reflected in the personality traits that influence their academic performance. So this is how the personality influences us. Now, coming to certain common personality disorders. Well, personality disorders as a concept have intrigued people, even those who are not belonging to this discipline of psychology. So we will just know in brief, we need not go into too much of depth, but we will just know in brief what are these various personality disorders, and for which if there is any person who is displaying this disorder, he should be referred to a counselor or to a clinical psychologist. Similarly, in the school setting, they are referred to the school counselors, and sometimes even the teachers, you know, who identify such cases, they refer them to the school counselors. Coming to paranoid. You must have heard this word paranoia, that don't be paranoid. Well, paranoid are those people who are always doubting on the loyalty of other people. You know, they have mistrust. They are full of suspicion and they feel that somebody is plotting against them, though there is no particular reason that these people, you know, should be mistrusting the others. Still, you know, they suffer from this particular disorder. And it is extremely sad, you know, that these people are occupied with these suspicion, with these thoughts of suspicion and mistrust throughout their day, and they're not able to do anything productive. So they feel nervous because they feel that people are trying to harm you or they do not like you. This is all about paranoid or paranoia. Okay, now the next category of the disorder that I would like to take up is antisocial. Antisocial, as you know, the word antisocial, that means against the society, antisocial. So there is violation of the rights of others, and antisocial people, they lack consideration. Any kind of behavior that they commit is always disruptive, you know, to other people. So that is the problem of antisocial personality. They're always having a pattern of persistent disregard for and the violation of the rights of others. This is the main characteristics of antisocial personality. Coming to schizoid. Schizoid means lack of interest in social relationship. Such kind of people, they prefer a solitary lifestyle. They do not enjoy any kind of close relations. They are emotionally very, very cold people. They are completely detached, apathetic, indifferent. So this is called schizoid personality. That means they want to cut off themselves from any kind of social engagements or social relationship and they want to be aloof. They want to lead a very independent kind of lifestyle, solitary lifestyle, where they do not want to have many people around them. Then coming to the next, which is borderline personality disorder. Borderline personality disorder is are those people who are having a feeling of worthlessness and unstable moods. You know, sometimes they will be very, happy, and other time they will be very sad. They have very negative perceptions about their self-image and behavior, and they result in, there's a lot of problem in relationship. There is because of insecurity, because of impulsive nature and the feeling of worthlessness. So they do not, they are not successful in social relationship. Coming to the next, which is narcissistic. Well, narcissism has gripped the society even these days. The person is in complete love for himself and they have a deep need for excessive attention. All our posts that go into the social media, which concentrate or which focus on ourselves, indicate this narcissistic side, which has slowly started evolving from one's personality. People are in total need of attention, admiration, because of their achievements, all right? Because of the various things that they're doing in their life. But they are completely, they're not at all having a regard or any kind of empathy for the others. So they have an exaggerated feeling of self-importance. So this is referred to as the narcissistic personality. Now coming to the next slide, this slide shows you the paranoid personality, antisocial personality. I've also included certain symptoms of schizoid personality, that is less desire of close relationship, choosing solitude, limited pleasure in activities, indifferent to praise or criticism, flat effect. Flat means absolutely no emotions at all. Even if there's a tragedy in the family, they will be completely flat in their emotions. They will not indicate, they will not show that they are being troubled or they are, you know, they're having any kind of problem. Again, we have a slide on borderline and narcissistic personality. You can see this person, extremely arrogant, grandiose, feeling a state of grandeur that I am, you know, one and all. Then you have delusions of power. There is complete empathy, lack of empathy. You know, people, they do not want to understand the other's problem. And borderline personality disorder, as I told you, unstable relationship, variations in mood, impulsive, emotional instability, episodes of dissociation, all these are indicators of borderline personality disorder. Coming to the next category, which is avoidant. Avoidant means, as you know, that the word avoidant comes from the word avoidance. That is, these people, they avoid others. They are characterized by the feelings of extreme social inhibition, inadequacy. That is, there is something which is lacking in me. And they are highly sensitive to criticism and rejection. So they are avoidant personality disorders. Then you have dependent personality disorders. Dependent personality disorders are those people who completely rely on others to satisfy their emotional and physical needs. That is called dependent personality disorder. The last, but not the least, is the obsessive compulsive disorder. You know, what is an obsession? An obsession is basically a kind of disorder where a person is preoccupied with a thought or an idea and he cannot get rid of it. For example, the obsession of the thought of cleanliness makes a person do a compulsive activity like washing the hands again and again. These days, we are also involved in washing our hands for hygiene, to prevent ourselves from any kind of infection time and again. It has almost become a compulsive activity. But these people who indulge in obsessive and who have got obsessive and compulsive disorder, their entire day goes in, you know, being preoccupied with a particular idea or, you know, washing their hands or counting or, you know, doing an activity repeatedly again and again. So this particular slide, it indicates your avoidant personality disorder. As I told you, avoid taking risks, inferiority complex, poor self-esteem. Self-esteem means value judgment about yourself. How do you value yourself as? All right. Rejection and negative perceptions. And these are the characteristics of dependent personality disorder. They cannot take basic decisions in their life. They are always dependent upon others because they feel that they will face disapproval in case they take their own decisions. All right. They cannot initiate any kind of projects. And there is a strong feeling of helplessness in these people. So this is the, these are the characteristics of dependent disorder. Obsessive compulsive is further indicated by this slide. You can see obsession, recurring irrational ideas. Compulsions are irrational acts. They can, obsessive behavior normally leads to compulsions. As I told you, if you're obsessed with cleanliness, you will be having a compulsive activity of washing the hands, right? And obviously, likewise, compulsive activities are because of obsessions. They can cause fear, worry, and anxiety. They can even cause bodily damage. So obsessions are contamination, losing control, harming somebody, losing important items, that is obsession. And compulsions are washing, cleaning, orderliness. You know, the books should be placed absolutely in order. No part should be jutting out. You know, they should be absolutely in line with each other. Double checking, following a strict routine. These are the examples of compulsive activities. So with this, we come to an end to the discussion about personality. As I told you, personality is the unique and stable characteristics of an individual. And personality has definitely a deep influence on our behavior. So with respect to marketing, you need to have an outgoing personality, a convincing personality, a personality which is able to influence the other people. And if there are disorders, we need to rectify the same. We need to approach a counselor or a clinical psychologist. And we need to break this particular myth that, or any kind of stigma that is persisting in the society, that if we are having a mental problem, you know, we should be socially cut off, or we should refrain ourselves from showing going to a clinical psychologist. Because as much as when we have a physical difficulty, we visit a doctor, it is likewise, whenever we are facing any problem and we are aware about this mental problem, we should be visiting a clinical psychologist to get rectified about the same. So with this, I end my session here. Thank you so much.